Let me just give y'all a history lesson. Okay, I'm seeing a whole lot of this. The Confederate flag is not hatred, it's history, or it's heritage, or it's whatever you believe. That is a lie. And I'm about to tell you why it's a lie. Okay? The Confederate states had three flags, okay? They had one flag at first that did not have the bars and stars, as they call it. Okay, the hateful banner, because that's what it is. Okay, it's hateful. I don't care what you say to anybody of color. It says, hey, I ride up with the Klan. That's what it says to us. So the Confederate States had three flags. They adapted the bars and stars was the second one. And then they moved it to the bars and stars in the corner. Hey, Chrissy, you already know this because I taught this in class. Had the bars and stars in the corner like the Mississippi state flag or the Georgia state flag. Okay, well, this is the deal. The Confederate states wanted to separate from the Union because they were adding other states that were not slave states. And then when they found gold in California, those plantation owners was like, hey, we can go to California and take our slaves and they can mine all the gold. And then we can continue to make money hand over fist. That is the real reason that the South seceded, because they wanted New Mexico, Arizona, Nevada, all those states south of the Mason-Dixon line to be slave states, agricultural states. Yes, the North didn't really need slaves because they had textile industry and they started to industrialize before the South. Now, another thing that y'all don't know, that the majority of the slaves were brought over here not to harvest cotton, but to harvest sugarcane. Sugarcane will kill you if you've never seen it. So the majority of the first slaves went to the Caribbean, went to South America. There are way more slaves that ended up in South America and the Caribbean than ended up in the United States. Why, you ask? I'm getting to that. Cotton was not a profitable crop until Eli Whitney's inventation of the cotton gin. You cannot separate cotton by hand. It's not profitable. But when he made the cotton gin, it was an easier way to more efficiently remove the seeds from the cotton. Okay? So then it became a profitable crop. That's when they started bringing in more and more slaves to the United States. So they could not only harvest cotton, but indigo and tobacco. Okay? Those three crops. Cotton, indigo, tobacco. All right. So another way, when y'all are saying it's protecting your southern way of living, what you don't know, and you haven't been over, is the Three-Fifths Compromise, that they decided they were going to pass a piece of legislation that said a black person was only 3/5 of a white person. This is out there. It's the Three-Fifths Compromise, because the South said they weren't getting equal representation in the legislative body of our government. So that's why they came up with the Three-Fifths Compromise. Okay. Blacks and slaves in the North weren't treated as badly as they were in the South, but it was still slavery either way. Okay? So then the North is kind of like, we don't really need slaves. We have servants. A lot of the indentured servants that came over here, their families went to the North, okay? Because of the industrialized economy they had up there, and there were other jobs they can get. Yes, I understand all whites in the South did not own slaves, but they wanted to protect the institution that made black people subservient to them. So I've seen kids say slavery for 400 years was a choice. Oh, it was a choice? Y'all don't know what happens when a slave rebellion was shut down. Y'all know about buck breaking? Or do you want to touch on the other thing, that I'm not mixed directly, but y'all aren't ready for that conversation? My lighter skin bears the scars of slavery. I am this complexion because of slavery. My mom is my complexion because of slavery. If you think I'm lying, go to McGee, Mississippi. Everybody that's a Womack is related. Black, white, other. We're all related because of that thing right there. Okay? Back to this flag in NASCAR. Okay? You say it's heritage and that's what it reflects for you.
The Black Detour is an independent media outlet that advocates for black people to not only be empowered, but informed on issues in the black community. We're part of a growing movement in America to empower black people all across the United States. For the latest in black news, history, and culture, click the link below to visit theblackdetour.com for black culture unfiltered.
Germany. Why? Because the Nazis lost. But in the United States, the Confederate flag still flies. Confederate monuments are still standing in the South. It's not okay. It's not okay. And today, on the day that Medgar Evers was slain in Jackson, Mississippi. Yes, the first slain civil rights leader was Medgar Evers. And then it was Malcolm X and then Martin. All right? Megger would have been bigger than Martin. I promise you that. Okay? I graduated from the school that created him, that was founded by Hiram Rebels, one of the first senators elected in the state of Mississippi after Reconstruction. See, what you don't know is that during Reconstruction, that's when a lot of black wealth was built from the ground up. Tulsa, Rosewood, all these places that they came into and destroyed. And when they did it, they flew the banner of the Confederate flag. So when you say it's about heritage, it is not about hate. That flag is literally drenched in my people's blood. Whether they be black or Indian, the Klan didn't discriminate. They took them all. They don't care. I have an aunt. She's born in Mexico. She's Mexican. I love her to pieces. I don't like any of this. None of this is okay. None of it. Okay? And I found the easiest way to get in and destroy the system. I'm a history teacher. Yes. I love what I do. Yes. Do I teach all the teaks? Yes. But then I add a little extra in. Put a little seasoning on it. You know what I'm saying? Because if there's something that you want to find out or research, just open a book. Please, just open a book. I want to educate y'all and I want to help y'all. But if you don't listen and you still say it's about heritage, it's about hatred. Okay? Hatred. There's no other way around it. It's about hatred. And we're trying to educate y'all, even though it's not our duties to educate you. It's not. But it is your duty to look and consider other people's feelings. That flag is racism. That flag is hatred. That flag has been, it's got eugenics all over it. A lot of y'all don't know what that is, but the Germans tried to employ that during the Final Solution when they wanted to eliminate the Jews. So until we address this ugly, ugly, ugly stain that we have on our country, it's going to continue to be like this. Don't tell me that you don't see color. Because if you say that, then you're saying that I'm going to discount what you are saying as an African American because I don't see color. Yes, systemic racism still exists. And then you're going to say, well, you're doing just fine. You know why I'm doing just fine? Because every woman in my lineage has a degree. Okay? My great-grandmother had to learn to speak Spanish so she could get a job as a janitor after having a master's degree. I was told at 10 years old by my great-grandmother that I couldn't go swim in a pool that was down the street from her house. Okay? Big, big, beautiful antebellum house that we stayed in Port Gibson. And I couldn't go to that pool at 10 years old. I'm 35 years old. That's not okay. There are things still going on in the United States today. And every time you say that flag is not hate but heritage, it's hateful. It's very hateful. And it needs to go. These Confederate monuments need to go. All of it needs to go. If you want stuff to change, then we have to address the scars that y'all have left on us. Okay? Y'all need to apologize to Colin Kaepernick. We can do more than just run behind balls and entertain y'all. All right? We can do all of that. It's okay for the honeypot founder to say, I want another little black girl to look at me and say, I can grow up and be this way. I can be successful. We need that. And it's okay. Just because we're saying that we can do it, it doesn't diminish anybody else. But through history, every time we've got it out the mud without anybody's help, somebody want to come in and burn it down. Tulsa, Rosewood. Okay? The only reason we were pushing for integration is because we wanted African-American schools to be funded the same way the white schools were funded. We don't really push into being into areas. All right? I don't know if y'all know this, but if that was the case, HBCU enrollment stays strong. All right? We're not trying to force our way of living or anything about our culture onto anybody else. We just want to be seen as equal. And then when we do it on our own, we don't want you coming in and taking it from us. Okay? There has to be some middle ground. There has to be some accountability. There has to be a conversation about what has gone on in this country. It's gone on long enough. And unless y'all gonna bring back the rights we had during Reconstruction, I'm gonna keep speaking up. I've been good. I've been quiet. Everybody been like, I know she going to say something. She going to pop out and give y'all the business. But I'm going to do it eloquently because y'all want me to be the angry black woman. I'm not going to be the angry black woman. But I am going to show y'all what it's like to be young, gifted, and black. My black is beautiful. And I'm not going to let anybody shrink that anymore. Okay? I am created and crafted beautifully by our maker. He decided he was going to take a little pinch of sugar, some honey, some sage, some mocha, everything, and create what you see. My hair is magic, and my skin doesn't age. And I want y'all to understand that genuinely, Black people, African Americans, we are so forgiving and loving when we shouldn't even be, but we are. Don't fear our equality, because we're not going to do y'all like y'all did us. We're better than that. And we've proven that for the last, what, I don't know, 500 something years. So when you tell us to just get over it, how about you become oppressed for 500 years and then say, just get over it. Okay? Okay? So I hope y'all learned something from this. You can share it. You can do whatever you need to do, because this is something that needed to be said. And I might have been the right person to say it. So I hope I've helped you and educated you. All right? So y'all go be good humans to each other. I'm out. Check out the nails. Yes, Lauren Slaves.